Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Diana Tripp. I'm a PhD student at University of Oradea, the doctoral school in economics. It is a great pleasure for me to attend this conference and to present to you a bibliometric analysis of research on entrepreneurial competencies in relation to higher education institutions. I will share the presentation. The article is entitled Mapping the Research on Entrepreneurial Competencies in Relationship with Higher Education Institutions. In entrepreneurship education, conventional wisdom is that educational institutions have a significant role in the formation of entrepreneurial competencies. However, the vigorous and multifaceted discussions on entrepreneurship and the mixed signals received from the market regarding the ultimate effectiveness of such transformational endeavors, open the way for more extensive research. For complex, multi-layered concept development to longitudinal studies assessment, the burgeoning literature has a multitude of nuances for which to mine. To map the state of the art of this dual research field and condense relevant emerging patterns, this paper intends to develop new bibliometric insight and trace an agenda for further inquiry into significant and relevant topics. For a significant time, the concept of entrepreneurship education encapsulated the force of opportunities and responsibilities for change and development, growth, and social economic well-being from both perspectives, the educators and the industries. The consensus on the symbiotic relationship between entrepreneurial initiative and the higher education institution did not translate fully into all intricacies of what entrepreneurship education implies. One area that needs further investigation is the area of entrepreneurial competencies. How are such competencies formed, and to what degrees are they determined by the learning ecosystem and specifically by the academic institution of nowadays? In the sprint to offer students greater employability currency, what significance is it offered to the entrepreneurial options? What are the right competencies for entrepreneurial initiative and how are they best formed? The modern entrepreneurship education dilemma is not only about the difficulty to teach students all the skills that would ensure their successful future activity in the entrepreneurial field, but also if this could be possible, as the pedagogic competencies and entrepreneurship education method are still being developed. There is no clear consensus on exact limits of the taxonomy of entrepreneurial competencies. Titel and Terzidis identified 5 approaches encompassing 14 distinct categories of competencies gathered from sources such as policymakers and competence assessment handbooks. The definitions differ in terms of the degree of inclusiveness, competence being defined as a combination of knowledge, skills, abilities, cognitive disposition, capacities, and other personal characteristics. Competence is finally condensed by Titel and Terzidis in 3 main categories: personal competence, social competence, and domain competence. Other researchers refer to 5 large groups of entrepreneurial competencies that can be taught and learned, recognizing the business opportunity, develop an entrepreneurial vision from the opportunity to the project, designing the business model, rendering them into a business plan, and boost an organization from the project to the structure. In order to map out the state of the art in entrepreneurship education with a focus on entrepreneurial competencies and higher education institutions, the following research questions were proposed. What authors, articles, journals, and institutions are leading the way with relevant research? And what research themes have been studied most, and what research streams are likely to be developed in the future? The methodology employed is the bibliometric analysis to map out the knowledge base and make use of Hesite and VozViewer for this purpose. The Web of Science platform was interrogated and it yielded a relevant sample of peer-reviewed article on which a series of bibliometric analyses were performed. The research techniques included a Boolean search using a combination of keywords, although the use of the keywords competence, ability, and skill in an interchangeable manner is debatable, the study allowed for the grouping of all these terms in the query in order to capture any fringing research done on this theme. In this way, a larger view of the term entrepreneurial competence is presented as presented in the title of this paper has been assumed. The research obtained a collection of 763 records, which were then filtered by language, English, Web of Science categories, and document types, resulting in 160 articles suited for our study. The time span of the research was all years. For the 160 articles, the following were extracted: the article title, authors' names and affiliation, journal names, number, volume, pages, date of publication, abstract, and cited reference. Then the bibliometric analysis was conducted employing the two specialized software, Hesite and VozViewer. The mapping of the research proposed herein is therefore obtained by grouping the findings for RQ1 and RQ2, then summarizing the learnings. Answering the first research question of the study needed a thorough analysis of the article collection, both for obtaining an image of the scientific output evolution in time and for ranking research and researchers in terms of impact. The early research output displayed a positive growing trend, with the peak of production in the year 2020. Rasmussen and Wright are the most productive authors according to both the ranking criteria, total local citation score and total global citation score, while the most cited work is an article published in 2011 by Rasmussen, Mosey, and Wright in the Journal of Management Studies, the article entitled The Evolution of Entrepreneurial Competencies, a Longitudinal Study of University Spin-off Venture Emergence. The most influential journal in terms of productivity score is Education and Training, with a solid share of 32% in the total research production of the top 10 journals. The UK and Spain yielded the first two positions at a close score in the ranking of leading countries publishing relevant research. The stateless Hesite feature is the visualization of the information flow in the domain. By using Hesite visualization capability, the study highlights the core works, those documents that are being highly cited, and the ones that are citing many other documents in the domain. Hesite historiograph exhibited Rasmussen's work, The Evolution of Entrepreneurial Competencies, a Longitudinal Study of University Spin-off Venture Emergence, as iconic for the research of entrepreneurial competencies and higher education institutions. After identifying the sample research done on entrepreneurial competencies and higher education institutions, the analysis focuses on the themes permeating this research, RQ2. For this, VozViewer and the analysis of keywords based on their co-occurrence in the article set were used. The software extracts the terms most used in the article and presents them in a visual form. VozViewer applies an algorithmic analysis in order to cluster the terms and provide insights into the research theme of the collection. The learnings of the present study reveal potential lines of future research, among which the following can be mentioned: exploring the gaps in research regarding the technological dimension related to entrepreneurship education. How can science parks build or develop competencies and incite entrepreneurial activity? What is their place in the education ecosystem of the future? And how can technology transfer be enhanced in order to fuel entrepreneurship? Exploring the potential of education innovations in building up competencies, what are some challenges in doing this, and how is the COVID quarantine disrupting or boosting their integration? The implication of these research findings are in no way negligible. The academic world, as stated before, can use the data to further the study both in the same direction or in interdisciplinary areas. Higher education institutions may want, for management purpose, to use these same findings, while public institutions and government can initiate diverse legitimate measurements, such as the one on publicly funded research, its value and impact. Since a bibliometric study is evaluating research by means of mathematics and statistics, identifying patterns and revealing gaps, the potential future theme-related research is based on these findings, while the limitation of the study suggests potential new lines of inquiry, new adjustments to be made to the present study. Thus, one limitation of the study that has been identified is the focus put solely on the articles yielded by the search query. Out of the initial result of 763 records, the result refinement reduced the number to 160 works, exclusively articles. The proceedings papers counted 348 records, which is 2 times a greater number than the collection analyzed herein. This means that relevant research has been a lot more in the focus of conferences than of journals articles. Therefore, it is expected that future similar research endeavors could also integrate the proceedings for a larger perspective. This paper's contribution to the state of the art on entrepreneurial competencies and higher education institutions resides on the fact that the analysis shines a direct light on a narrow field of study that accommodates these two major research topics, evaluating its stamina and its future potential for more in-depth analysis. Based on a comprehensive analysis, this paper's new findings can be of critical importance to assess emerging trends with valuable implications for future research in the underexplored field of entrepreneurial competencies and higher education institutions. We've included here a selected bibliography of books, articles, and other material used by the authors. And the acknowledgement, this paper received financial support throughout the project SmartDoc High Quality Programs for Doctoral Students and Postdoctoral Researchers of the University of Oradea to increase the relevance of research and innovation in the context of regional economy. Thank you for your attention throughout this presentation.